Electrospinning is the method of using high voltage to produce ultra-small diameter fibers. In the electrospinning process, a polymer solution is held inside a syringe needle pump. A high voltage power supply is used to create a charged jet of polymer solution. When this jet travels in air, the solvent evaporates and leaves behind a charged fiber. Because of the intense electric field that exists between the needle tip and rotating collector, the fibers are electrostatically elongated and collected on the metal sheet. The apparatus used in the electrospinning process is shown here. The hardware consists of high voltage power supply, syringe pump, and collector assembly. In the rest of the video, I will go over each subassembly and demonstrate how the electrospinning machine operates. Let's first go over the drum collector assembly. The drum collector is detachable and it is driven by a DC motor. To install the drum collector, align the gears and insert it gently in place. Place the collector assembly on top of the aluminum base. Connect the DC motor to the controller. Plug in 12 volt and provide power to the control panel. Turn on the collector motor. The collector rotation speed can be adjusted by turning the dial on the control panel. In this section, we will illustrate the syringe pump usage. On the control panel, push the switch upward to reverse and turn on the telecone motor switch. The pump motor will rotate at maximum speed when traveling in the up direction. After the highest position is reached, carefully remove the syringe from the white tube housing. When you are ready to run experiments, fill the syringe with liquid sample. For alignment purposes, install two O-rings as shown. This particular syringe size is 10 cc. Insert the plunger end of the syringe into the white tube housing. Then lock the syringe by placing the hand tab into the slot. Set the pump direction to dispense and turn on the pump. When the pusher inside the white tube is engaged with the syringe plunger, liquid droplets will form at the tip of the needle. Dispense speed can be adjusted using the potentiometer located on the control panel. Connect the high voltage clip to needle. Warning! Make sure the high voltage power supply is off before touching the clip. Let's now go over the high voltage section. LabMate is an adjustable high voltage switch mode power supply. It is compact, lightweight, and versatile. Your front panel control for the generator are as follows. Voltage displayed in 5 digits. Voltage adjustment dial with turn counting indicator. Remote control receptacle. Indicator light when the unit is under remote control. Indicator light when output is in constant current mode. Current display. Current adjustment dial. High voltage on-off switch. On the back of the generator you will find M5 threaded stud for grounding. Main power on-off switch. DC input connector, high voltage output connector. Now that we have gone over the basics of the high voltage power supply, let's complete the setup by going over the high voltage connection. Proper grounding is very important. Make a secure ground connection between the high voltage power supply and earth ground. Make the 24 volt connection. Connect the high voltage power supply to telecom tower. The electrospinning machine is ready for demonstration. Depositing the electrospun fibers on an aluminum foil works well because it is easier to gather samples with different parameters that you can go back to analyze later. You can see here that we're using double-sided tape to hold the aluminum foil in place. Wrap the foil around the drum collector. Try to keep it tight and cut off the excess foil. After the metal foil wrapping is complete, put the drum collector back in place. From the control panel, set the syringe pump flow rate and collector speed. After that, turn on the motors. On the high voltage power supply, adjust the current setting to the smallest output value that will work for your setup. In this particular demonstration, electrospinning did not require any current output, so the current limit was kept below 0.1 milliamp. This will limit the current output in case there's a short. Next, set the high voltage using the dial indicator. When everything is in place, turn on the high voltage output. Observe the electrospinning action and adjust the high voltage value, collector speed, and pump flow rate to get the desired result. Electrospinning is a fascinating fabrication technique. With a small benchtop setup like the one you've seen, you can do a lot of interesting research and development. Do you have a material you want us to electrospin? You can leave the material suggestion in the comment sections below. For more information, come visit us at sprucescience.com. Good luck and have fun!